la vida. Tu boca mi refugio, mi abrigo más seguro. Tu corazón la fe, por ti volví a creer.
Fashion world. But I decided to adopt structures that already have a steady market. For example, denim pants. Denim pants are classic but already have a defined consumer. I just made changes in the details. Check this out. See the stitches? It plays a huge part in the decorative elements. I also improved the design of the denim. And apart from that, I did enhance the denim's texture to make it more comfortable to wear. Check also the edging. You will notice that I patterned the edging after cotton t-shirts. You know, cotton t-shirts are a classic too, but by playing with them, we'll take a look at what I made here. Are you okay, sir?
Yes, don't worry. I'm okay. I'm just tired, Angela. I haven't had any sleep.
You had loads of work, Mr. Roberto. That's why I didn't want to wake you up earlier.
You like roses, don't you?
Absolutely. I just thought that roses would add appeal to my creation, and since they're way too pretty, I decided to use it in the designs.
All right.
Take a look. For example, what you see here can be done with thousands of tiny roses and turn it into something more elegant. Here. I won't show you anymore, so I won't bore you.
Okay, Mariana. Congratulations. I like your designs. They're very pretty.
Did you really like my design?
Yes, absolutely, Mariana. Apart from the designs you've shown, I also like the business plan. It looks as if it were done by a real professional.
Well, I have to give credit to the internet. I never had formal background in making a business plan. I just found that on the internet.
But it reflects the reality of the fashion world.
Well, you have to look at it again, Fabricio.
I read the most important parts, and your business plan seems like a good business opportunity. So I'll support you, Mariana. It's feasible. So I'm interested, and I want to be your partner in this project.
Wait a minute, you know, I showed you this business plan because I wanted your opinion and not because I'm going to ask you for any money.
Don't worry. I know you're not asking for money, but I want to help you in all I can do. In a week or two, we'll start setting up the workshop.
Oh, but Fabricio, I really think you should think it through a little bit more.
I've decided. I already thought about it.
Any problem with it, Mariana. If Fabricio wants to finance the workshop, well, just take the money right away, Mari. Get it out of his hand.
Get it out of his hand?
Don't ever think twice and just accept it right away. Listen, when a guy decides to help, all right, when he opens his wallet, you shouldn't give them time to think.
Why do you say such ugly things, Scarlett?
Because I'm your evil sister.
No, you are not my evil sister.
Yes.
You're my lovely sister, the one that's too ambitious and wants to have it all. Not to mention that you're materialistic as well, which does scare me.
Whatever. Well, regret comes in the end. So if you don't accept his help, you'll come to me crying. When that happens, I'll ignore you because you didn't listen. So if I were you, I'll accept it. Okay, tell me the truth. Explain to me why you don't want to take Fabricio's money, Mariana. I don't get you.
Because Fabricio wants to be my business partner for personal reasons. Because he likes me and he wants to be closer to me.
Well, but that sounds good. Open your eyes, Mari. He might be the one you need. Someone with great resources that will commit to you all the way.
Oh, I don't know. He didn't even take a real look at the business plan. Mm. That can turn out to be a problem later on, Scarlett.
I don't think so.
Yes.
Hey, Mariana, come here. You have a phone call.
Thank you, Daddy.
You know what to do. If it's Fabricio, take the mile instead of the inch.
Hello?
Mariana Garcia?
Yes, speaking.
Good evening. This is Fabricio's wife. Do you hear me, huh?
Yes, I can hear you. But please, I'm not in the mood for some kind of
joke. No, Mariana, I am not kidding at all. Fabricio is my husband. We've been married for more than 10 years. We have 2 children, and you are destroying our beautiful marriage.
Oh, stop crying, my sister. Please, I beg you, you can't go on crying for someone like him that isn't worth it, so stop it.
I'm crying because I've been fooled, and that hurts me, Scarlett.
Okay, I totally understand you. But, Mari, it's unbelievable. So, Fabricio never told you he was married?
No, never! I even asked him several times. I asked him if he's married, and he answered, no, I'm not. He always denied it. He told me he was single. That good for nothing has been fooling me all this time. I called him now, and you know what he said? The only thing he told me was to stay with him, because in the end, he was going to get separated.
Oh, that's good. So you still have a chance.
No, I don't want anyone to get separated because of me, Scarlett. That's it. We're finally over. I don't want to hear about that guy ever again. This is over. It's over. It's over.
Here, take this.
Oh, I'm so angry. Why does this always happen to me? When it's not guys that have a background of being a mama's boy and aren't willing to have a lifetime commitment. They're bums, or drunkards, or womanizers, or they're married. You know, it's as if I had a magnet to attract men with problems.
Well, I agree. You really are unlucky when it comes to men, Mariana. But who knows? There is still someone out there for you, so don't lose
hope. No, I don't believe that. No, I'm done trying.
So what do you mean?
You hurt me. I no longer want to have anything to do with men. From now on, I'm just going to concentrate on my workshop and nothing else. No more men in my life.
Oh, Mari. You'll have to excuse me there, but that's the other thing. So where are you planning to get the money you will use for the workshop?
I'm going to go to the White Textile to check on some fabric orders. And after that, I'll try to present my proposal to the president. I hope he likes my designs and accepts my business plan.
I know you can do that, sis.
Thanks.
Oh, come on. Okay, could you do me a favor, please? Don't be so stupid. We are the ones handling this event, so we don't need an event organizer here. Excuse me, Mr. Roberto. I'm sorry, sir. I just left the, I left the designs for the fabrics at your office.
Okay, thank you. But we'll just talk about it later. And I hope your designs are much better now than what you did last month.
Weren't you a little bit harsh with that man, Roberto?
That man is Otoniel, creative manager of White Textiles, and he's not doing his job, and I'm going to have to replace him. So what do you think, Dad? Would you like an office next to this one?
No, no, this is your company because your grandfather left it to you. And I don't want you to give me stocks or be your employee, Roberto.
There is another option. You can be the president of the White Foundation, Dad. To give you an idea, the president of the White Foundation is completely independent. And there are meetings with a board, which I never go to, so that you can do whatever you want, if you will accept what I'm offering.
Does Mr. Roberto know you?
No, I'm afraid he doesn't know me because I'm just new at the company and I haven't had the chance to meet him in person.
Then I'm very sorry, miss. I can't give you an appointment with him. Thanks, Rosie.
But then I really need to talk to him.
I'm sorry, I'm busy handling with the applicants. Why don't you talk to the administrative manager?
No, I don't want to talk to the admin manager. I'm not interested in getting a raise or a promotion or anything like that, Angela. Listen, I have a business plan that I want to present to the company. And that's the reason why I need to speak to Mr. Roberto. I'm crazy, aren't I? You think a sales clerk like me can't possibly have any idea about business. And that's why you're smiling.
No, that's not it.
But that's what you're thinking.
No, I'm thinking that your name sounds familiar to me. What did you say your name was?
Mariana Garcia.
And you work as a sales clerk at the store downtown, am I right? Yes, that is right. I knew it rang a bell. Mariana Garcia, you have been granted a scholarship from the White Foundation to study at the university.
The White Foundation has resources, but it's an organized debt. It needs a president with a high profile, someone that can provide leadership, and I know you have that. I'm so much willing to give the necessary funding for the foundation as long as everyone respond to serious programs.
You promise that I will have independence?
Yes, I promise you that. And if you present an interesting program for the foundation, you can always count on me on having the money you need.
Why are you offering this, Roberto?
Because I'm your son, and I need you, Dad.
I had forgotten about this scholarship. I thought my application had been rejected.
Yes, they're a little unorganized at the foundation, but well, the scholarship is there for you to go and study.
So my sister could study because I asked it for her.
Okay, so what are you waiting for? Go to the university to enroll her. First semesters only have the tuition fee, but if your sister studies and doesn't flunk any subjects, they will pay for her tuition until she graduates.
That's wonderful.
Call your boss right away and ask for permission. Since this is work-related, he shouldn't give you any trouble.
Thank you very much.
The White Foundation is very delayed in informing the beneficiaries of the scholarship program. We have to solve that problem right away.
I don't see any problem there. I think the money that had been directed to those scholarships can be relocated for other projects.
Excuse me.
Oh, excuse me. We need money now. We have a lab at the university that needs funding.
What do you think, Roberto?
Those scholarships were already awarded, and besides, we won't let these people down.
I think people will understand it.
I don't understand.
It's plain and simple. The term to make the scholarship has already expired. Just be back next semester. You might get a spot next semester, don't you think?
No, I'm really sorry, but I don't like the idea. My sister needs to enroll this semester, and that's precisely why I'm here.
Well, then I'm sorry, but there is nothing I can do, miss.
If you would really insist on an additional time limit so that the scholarship holders can enroll, we will grant that to them. I will speak to my secretary to inform her about that particular matter.
All right, Dad, I have to leave. I have an appointment with the people from the textile mill. See you later. Dr. Quevedo, thank you very much for all the help and the cooperation. And please discuss the matter of the funding of the lab with my father and other possible programs you have in mind. He decides. He's the president of the White Foundation.
It was very nice to have you here, Mr.
Thank
Roberto.
I'll see you later, son. Uh-huh. So, apart from the lab, what else?
No, Angela. I'm still here at the university, so I'll be late. Angela, cancel my meeting with Tony. I'd rather meet him at the end of the day. And if the man from the mill arrives, tell him to wait for me. I'll see you later. Bye. To throw these papers in the trash?
Because the people from the White Foundation are very incompetent. I was just told that I missed the deadline to enroll my sister.
No, actually, the enrollment for scholars has been extended. You can ask the secretary about it. The dean just made the decision 2 minutes ago. The scholarship is still active. And if you want, I can help you fill out the papers.
No, thank you. I can do it myself.
Wait, did I say something to upset you? You didn't even let me tell you my name.
Well, I'm not interested in knowing your name.
But why?
Well, because I don't want to. I made a promise to myself, and I'm going to honor it.
But tell me, what would happen to your promise if we meet again?
I don't think that we'll meet again.
What if we do?
We'll just see then. Until that time, we will be known as two people with anonymous names.
Limits had been extended?
Someone very well informed.
Oh, very well informed, because that decision was made a second ago.
the fashion capital in the world. Today, our own compatriot conquers the stage to show her beauty. And here she is, the moment the public of Milan and the television viewers all over the world were waiting for, Scarlett. Scarlett has had an impressive career as a supermodel in Miami. She has modeled for exclusive fashion designers such as Valentino and Marc Jacobs. And now, Scarlett is the first and only Colombian to ever walk this famous catwalk. She is also the first Colombian model to be recognized internationally. The first and only, the only one.
Well, the only one? So what do you mean? No way, Scarlett. Can't be the only one. Don't be so selfish. If you're going to enter the modeling world, I'm sure you'll become successful and going to be famous. And you're going to Milan, Italy, to do a runway like a princess on the catwalk. Huh? But you can't be the only one. Don't be selfish.
Are you nuts, Adri? Listen, I was telling you about my own dream. My own dream, all
Absolutely,
right?
It was your dream.
About my dream.
But listen to me, Scarlett. I can be successful in your dream, can't I? My goodness, friend, I can imagine both of us in the catwalk. Look me in the eyes and tell me seriously if I'm your best friend, yes or no.
Well, yes, of course you are my
best
friend.
Oh, very good. If that's the case, then put me at the same level as you are,
all
right?
So what you actually meant was you want me to include you in my own dream?
Of course.
Don't you have anything more to say?
Oh, Scarlett, you know what? I'm starting to feel that you're a bad friend this close.
Stop kidding around, please. I wonder what Mariana is doing home so
early. Hey, Scarlett!
She's here already.
Come here. Come here, come with me.
Hurry up
what
now.
What is it? Oh, hey,
I don't want to know, too. I want to know it.
Okay, guys, lend me your ears. I have good news for everyone. I got you a scholarship for half the tuition to study at the University del Sur. Congrats to you, Scarlett.
Really?
What, don't you think that's good news, sis?
Absolutely, it's really good news. Aren't you glad, dear? You're going to study.
I'm glad, but at the University of del Sur?
Well, I'd prefer you to study at Harvard or Los Andes, but but since we're poor, Scarlett...
No, I won't accept that. We are not poor, sis.
No?
No. We have no money, which is very different from being poor. And having no money is temporary. We'll get out of it.
I wish. But to get out of poverty, you have to study.
Don't you want to study?
Angela, I need the complete list of the beneficiaries for the scholarship for the Wine Foundation, okay? Please include a complete resume with a photo.
As you wish, sir. Excuse me, Don Roberto.
The company will pay for half of your tuition so you can go to college, Scarlett. You can't miss out on a big opportunity like this, little sister.
Oh, Mari, but I don't want to go to college. And I won't need it anyway because soon I will be a top model.
Oh, yeah, I agree. Both of us. We're going to be models, very famous models, Mariana. And you will soon see us walk the runway in Milan.
Well, I suggest that you stop daydreaming for now. Because in this country, if you don't want to study, you're not going anywhere. That's the real deal. Anyway, here's the name of the lady you have to look for at the university. You have to enroll today because class has already started. And sign the papers, too. Do it right now. And here's the money to pay for half of the tuition fee. Take care of this. I worked very hard so I could send you to school. I have to go.
And where are you going, Mariana?
Well, I have to go back to work, Dad. I need to continue working so we won't be poor anymore. And you're welcome. You're welcome, Scarlett.
At the factory, they informed me that we still have a stock of this kind of fabric.
Yes, madam. I believe we still have this fabric.
Well, it's perfect. Prepare a roll of this fabric and send it to the workshop.
Okay, the truth is I don't think we have enough to send you.
How much is left?
The problem is, I don't know. The sales attendant that handles that stock hasn't arrived yet. But let me find out for you.
Thank
please.
You.
Mariana! Mariana! Fercho, do you know if we still have this fabric?
Good morning.
Mariana, I'm glad you're here. Do we still have this fabric?
Yes. This is 4,556 satin. We should have some in storage.
I need a roll of this right now.
Well, I still have to check the inventory if we have
enough. Well, do it quickly. Can't you see that this is for the big boss's wife, Miss Beatrice? The wife of Roberto White. She's here in person, can you imagine? And of all the days, why did I give you permission to be late today? Oh, come on and hurry up!
Thank you. Yes, here it is. 4,556 satin with the same color that you need. What we have available is about 98 meters long.
Okay, then. Please send all of it to my office, Miss Beatrice.
We'll send it right away, Miss Beatrice.
Well, we were also looking for some chiffon that's not totally even, but with a little design on it. We didn't bring a sample, but it's emerald green.
That must be the Spring Chiffon 47. Let me check if it's available. How many meters do you need?
Please take care of the fabrics I need. I'm just going to take this call.
Hey, put on your uniform. Don't you see that you're dealing with the spouse of Mr. Roberto White?
Hello, Beatrice. How are you?
I'm fine. And how about you?
Fine. I'm fine. I'm doing good.
I'm glad to hear that.
The fabric is stored upstairs. I'll bring it down for you, but will you please give me a second while I change, because otherwise I'll get into trouble.
And what's with the t-shirt?
Why? Is there something wrong with it?
No, there's nothing wrong with it. It's very pretty. And where did you buy the shirt?
Well, I made it myself.
Are you serious? Well, I think the design's great. Are you sure you made that yourself?
Yes. Do you like it?
I love it. You're a gifted artist.
So you're back?
Yes, I'm back in town, Anne.
And?
We have to talk.
So I'm guessing I will see you in the house later tonight?
Well, if that's what you want, I'll see you at the house tonight.
Okay, honey. I'll wait for you there.
If I say I like it, it's because I do. It's just that the design is so simple, so elemental, but at the same time very effective. It also has some ethnic vibe as well.
Yes, I was inspired by an Indian illustration.
Of course, but you modified it to have an urban style to make it look current.
That too.
Why haven't you put on your uniform yet?
Yes, Mr. Cifuentes, I was about to change, but I was going to bring down the fabric first for Sir Juan Carlos. Mm.
I have to go now.
What happened?
Let's go. Juan Carlos, he's back. He's back and he wants to talk to me and he's going to the house tonight. I'm so happy I'm going to reconcile with Roberto. I'm so happy, I can't believe it.
Are you getting back together with Beatrice?
No, Dad, I'm not. On the contrary, I'm actually divorcing Beatrice.
I don't understand. You told me that you wanted to start a brand new chapter in your life, that you wanted to fix your situation with Beatrice.
And in this case, a divorce is the only way of fixing the situation. Anyway. Do you like your new office, Dad?
Yes, this new office is not bad. But what's terrible is that you're going to divorce Beatrice.
So Scarlett's going to study at the university?
Yes. I already gave her the money, so she should be enrolling as we speak.
Well, that's great. That scholarship came down directly from heaven.
Yes, directly from heaven.
Hey, what's wrong?
Oh, Fairchild, life is so strange. Well, today I met a guy. And? Well, I treated him so terribly.
But why? What happened?
Because I was in a bad mood earlier and I was really rude to him. And he was very nice to me.
And now you feel so sorry.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, but now there's nothing I can do.
Angela, what happened to the list I requested?
Yes, Sir Roberto. I already requested the foundation to give me a copy, but you know how slow the people there are for everything.
Well, bring it to me as soon as you have it, okay? And remember, I need a list with pictures attached. I want to know where the people were helping to go to the university.
Where are we going, Scarlett? Aren't you going to enroll at the university?
N-O.
No? No?
Oh, congratulations! High five, sis! You finally learned how to read.
Oh, please don't make fun of me, okay?
Hey, stop saying stupid things like that, Adriana. Come with me, let's go to a store. I know it's really cool and classy.
What kind of store? Fun.
For clothes.
Why are we going to a clothing store?
You'll find out later.
What are we doing here, Scarlett? This place is so expensive. I heard they even charge you for breathing.
Come on, just relax.
Don't tell me to relax. Come on. Hey, look.
But
look.
Why?
Look at the way those sales clerks look at us as if we are not worthy to set our feet here. And they dress better than us.
Adriana, stop being so self-conscious, okay? Will you please stop acting as if you were some kind of poor chick?
But I am. A poor girl, Scarlett.
You're mistaken. You're not
You're
poor.
You're wrong. I'm poor.
We're not poor. No, Adriana.
We're poor, not poor, okay.
Because look.
Put that money away.
No, why would I?
You're not going to spend the money your sister saved for your education in this place.
No, Adriana. I'm going to make an investment.
I don't know.
This money will be for my clothes.
That's not a good idea.
Excuse me.
How may I help you?
We're just looking.
Oh, I want to have that black jacket. Mm-hmm. Adriana, come here.
Well, Scarlett, please stop.
This is beautiful.
I'm pretty expensive. It is imported.
Yes, I know, and I'm not asking you to give it to me for my birthday. Mm. It already passed. Thank you anyway. Mm. I just want to try this jacket on. It's gorgeous. I'll try this on right now. I want this jacket.
But of course, in what color would you like it?
Black. Just like this one. Okay. And I like these boots, too.
All right.
The boots just
all
like
right,
these
right.
as well. Here, I'll take this one. And this top?
Yes, Miss.
Miss, do you also have leather skirts?
Yes. Come with me to the dressing room now.
Go ahead. I'll follow you. Come on, let's go.
Where are we going?
To Milan, my gorgeous friend. And this is our first stop.
You are crazy,
let's go.
Scarlett.
Shut
You're
up and let's
get
go.
In trouble.
It's just an illusion. It's never enough.
Oh, Scarlett, but you already spent it all.
But I still wasn't able to get the top.
Well, yeah, but the point is you spent it all.
You know what? I'm gonna ask my sister Mariana to make a really pretty shirt for me to complete my gorgeous look.
Oh, Scarlett, I can't believe you spent
Adriana,
it all.
For Pete's sake, stop saying that over and over.
Don't you realize what you just did?
I know what I did. Of course I do. I'm not stupid. For the record, what I did was an investment. Because when we go to the textile fair tomorrow, my dear friend, they won't take their eyes off of us. Mm-hmm. All they'll say is, wow.
Is that true that we're going to a textile fair?
Absolutely.
But wait. Why are we going to a textile fair in the first place?
What do you
place?
Mean by that? That's where the most important people in the modeling world are gonna be. They're the ones that will open the doors for us.
Ah, so we are going to Milan!
Soon enough. But first we have to go to this textile fair tomorrow.
Yeah, right.
Just grab these bags. Help me out. I don't want Mariana to see me with all of these clothes. Take care of it.
Yeah.
I'll go by your house tomorrow. We'll change clothes, get all dolled up, and we'll go to the textile fair, okay?
Let's do it!
Mr. Cifuentes?
What do you want, Fernando?
The thing is, I was looking at the customs manifest, and I thought you should know if there's an inconsistency.
And just what are you doing looking at the customs manifest?
Well, it's my job to check these things.
Your job is to do the accounting, and that's all. No snooping around like a detective or accusing anyone for that matter.
No, I'm not accusing anyone. I was just saying that in the importation of clothes report I checked, I saw an irregularity.
Just what I needed. Now I have to deal with an ambitious subordinate accusing me of committing contraband.
Are you?
Listen, give those back right now.
What happened?
I'll tell you later.
You know very well that I've always tried to stay out of it. When you started having problems with Beatrice, I didn't interfere at all. And when you got separated and you left the country, you didn't hear a word from me. Since I know for a fact all relationships go through crisis and sometimes you need to get away to think things through. But to get a divorce, getting a divorce is something definitive.
I know, Dad. I know all that.
Here's my advice. Think about it. Beatrice is an angel. You'll never get a woman like her, I'm telling you.
Dad, I'm divorcing Beatrice in the first place because I don't want to be with a woman exactly
Roberto,
like her.
Don't you realize that you're in a good marriage? A stable relationship with a woman who's so marvelous. Please don't throw it all away. Living alone is no good. And I know what I am talking about. When your mother passed away, it was all over for me.
Oh, Dad, my story is very different from yours because you truly loved my mother.
So you're telling me you don't love Beatrice?
Excuse me. Mr. Roberto, here's the list of the beneficiaries of the White Scholarship Program, with their profiles attached as well.
That's perfect. Excuse me, Dad. I'm sorry, Angela. This is not a complete list.
That's strange. That is what Vicky gave me, and she said that it was in the files of the Foundation.
Well, yes, but the person I'm looking for is not here.
I'll look into it. I'll get back on you. Excuse me.
Do you see? The Foundation is one big mess. Thank goodness you already took care of that problem.
Who are you looking for exactly anyway?
I don't know her name yet, Dad, but I will find her soon.
I was checking out the customs records we have on file. And you know what? For every roll of fabric that we import legally, Cifuentes sells two or three rolls under the table.
So I guess the sales reports are fabricated, or else they would have figured it out easily at the corporate office.
Oh yes, fabricated books and phony invoices, you name it, and perhaps they have an accomplice at corporate. In other words, Cifuentes is one fat crook and I have to quit soon.
Fair
if I still
know.
Work there, I could really get into trouble and get thrown in jail.
But the solution is not to run away, Fernando. We have to report this incident.
And where are we going to report this?
Well, at the textile plant. If you're sure of the irregularities, we have to report this matter to the powers that be.
Mariana, how can you even think of that? I don't want to get in bigger trouble. And I advise you not to do it either. We haven't been here long, and they will never listen to us.
Yes, you're right about that. For example, today I tried to talk to Mr. Roberto, and, well, they practically slammed the door right in my face.
Mariana, we have to talk.
And who the heck is this guy?
I'll see you later, Fairchild.
Do you want me to come with you?
No.
Are you sure?
Everything's okay.
Here's the deal, boss. Those patterns will be amazing once it's printed on a Teflon, which will be covered with sequins. And, well, I'm imagining something soft and tight that goes down that will definitely amaze
people.
The
thing is, that pattern you design cannot be done over a viscous Teflon fiber. Because you should know that material is too thin to support that huge amount of ink.
Well, I thought so, but the thing is, like, to make them go wild and steer away from the norm and... come on, Roberto, you have to admit that these designs are absolutely spectacular. It's shockingly good.
Well, I don't like these designs.
You haven't seen this red one, for instance, because it is absolutely amazing, and it's the latest fashion trend. Right now, flowers are it, and we are going to be reborn. The way they're coming back like spring, we're going to be the talk of
the town.
And wherever you look, you will see gorgeous flowers.
Flowers are coming back, but not those. At least not here in this textile company. Tony, haven't you thought about doing something with roses?
With roses?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because man, those flowers are simple, but they are a classic. They have been a symbol of elegance for several centuries. Roses are just like Chanel.
Chanel was an idiot. And besides, I don't imitate anyone.
Well, Tony, I feel that we're in the same situation we were a month ago. There's no evolution in your work, and we are the top textile company. What we need are designs that are cutting edge. It is we who will mark and set the trends in this industry. If you know what I mean.
Oh well, I can modify a few details, three or four things, and we'll be done
with it. The problem is not about modifying a couple of details. You should throw these in the trash and bring me something fresh, something unique.
Yes, sir.
I beg you, please understand me. I was going to tell you about my marriage, but you see, things between the two of us happen so quickly.
Now just be quiet. Because what is going on between the two of us is absolutely nothing.
But hey, you already told me that you're already falling in love with me.
Yes, because I was stupid. I was a fool to believe in a person like you. I was wrong about you.
But we were doing so well.
No, we were doing horribly. I just didn't know it.
How can you say such a harsh thing?
Your beloved wife called me, Fabricio. She confronted me. She was indignant.
You know my wife is a crazy witch.
Crazy? No. She had every right to do that. She's fighting for what is true.
Mariana, listen to me. I swear to you, I am going to divorce my wife. Thanks to you, I understood a lot of things.
I have no interest whatsoever in knowing what you understood. If I accepted to come here and sit at this table, it was not to listen to you. It was so you would listen to me. I do not want to see you again. Don't you even dare call me. I really don't want to have anything to do with you anymore.
I don't think that is fair to me, Mariana.
Oh, really? Don't talk to me about what is fair and what is not. Stop being such a jerk. Don't you dare look for me ever again. Do you understand? I want you to disappear from my life.
Good evening.
Good evening. Hey. Did you lose your keys?
No, I just didn't want to use...
But why? This is your house. Do you want to have dinner, or would you like some wine first? I have that Argentinian Merlot you like so much.
Well, that's okay.
Yes?
Some red wine with it at the spot, so yes.
I'll go get it. I'm so very happy.
And why is that?
Because everything is going so well for me.
Very well.
Oh, come on, stop reading and do something worth your time for Pete's sake. Come on, Dad, pamper me. Come on, hug me. You haven't given me love or anything
in
a long time.
Well then, my little princess.
Oh, Mari, please get the door.
But I'm busy designing your shirt, remember, princess?
Oh, well, hold on. You continue reading, Dad. I wonder who it is. It's just you.
Can I come in?
Have you come to see Mariana?
No. I came here to see you.
Well then, you make the toast.
All right then, to the whole truth.
Well, that is always nice to hear.
Yes, but sometimes it's very difficult to say. So cheers.
Cheers.
Beatriz, I have lied to you several times already.
Oh, my love, but that is all in the past. It is all forgotten.
I don't believe you.
Oh, well. Not exactly forgotten, but I am willing to forgive you anyway.
But I don't want your forgiveness.
Oh, my love, why do we have to start talking about unpleasant things right at this moment? We are going to start a brand new chapter. At least that's how I feel right now.
Me too. And that's precisely the reason why we have to be very honest with each other. Beatriz, I do not want to continue deceiving you.
Because you won't have to. We are going to be together again and
no,
we are
Beatriz,
going
no.
to...
We're not going to live together anymore. This marriage is over. Beatriz, I want to get a divorce.
Rachel, please do not provoke me this time. Please, understand me. I beg you, please.
Scarlett, yes, I understand you. But I have this strong feeling that you still love me. Am I right?
Yes, you're right. I have feelings for you. But it's totally different, Rachel. Very different. Very, very different from what you're thinking. My feelings for you are more like this one. Like this. My friendly little finger. Because you're my friend, Rachel. That's why I can't love you that
Scarlett,
much.
Remember, I was your boyfriend. I was the man you had your first kiss. Why can't you love me
now? Okay. Listen. Please, no. Please don't take it seriously because it was just a friendly kiss, Fernando, and I will make sure it won't happen again.
Forgive me, but it's just that I can't help myself, Scarlett. I am only asking you to remember that you and I cared for each other before and that we shared same feelings. You love me, I know it. Because when I touch you, you tremble.
Please stop it. Yes, I do tremble. Yes, I tremble, but it turns out, Fernando, that I do really shake when all men touch me. And not out of love, or not because I'm afraid of them, but because of the pleasure that I feel, Fernando. Because I'm a woman and I get attracted to men. It's normal.
But why? Why do you have to put down yourself?
What do you mean by that,
Yes, Scarlett, you are degrading yourself. Anyone who hears you talking like that will probably think that you are a tramp or a prostitute. That will just go with anyone. Though we both know deep in our hearts that it isn't true.
Is that what you think of me, Fernando?
Oh, come on! You don't get the idea! Scarlett, I know you're a dignified woman. You are not a slut. But you think you know everything. You don't even think the feelings of others. But you know what? I know what's going on with you. You want me to be out of your life because you know that you won't get anything from me, right? And because you have so much dreams in your life, you don't want to be out in this world without achieving anything. I know you are a woman who will do everything in life by making use of your beauty, your courage, and your intelligence. But you know what? I just hope that you will succeed, Scarlett, because I'll do everything just to get ahead of you. And someday you will realize that.
I'm so sorry, Fercho. Yolanda, stop. It's all right. Just leave it.
I just need to pour some salt on this spot.
We'll pour some later.
Yes, ma'am, please excuse me.
Are you all right?
No, I feel horrible. But why should you care?
Beatrice, no. I don't mean to hurt you at all.
Then stay with me. Please don't leave me. Roberto, I love you. Don't do this to me, please. I beg you, don't leave me. Don't abandon me. Oh my God, what am I doing? I'm begging a man to love me. Do you see what I am doing? I am begging for your love.
Please, don't do this. I don't want to see you this way.
Is that what you came here to tell me? That we are getting a divorce?
Yes.
Well, you did it. You can now leave.
But it's just that.
Just leave!
Mrs. Beatrice, should we serve dinner already?
No, Yolanda, he already left. Just bring the salt for that stain.
Yes, ma'am, Beatrice.
So you really had coffee with Fabricio earlier?
Yes. And I put him in his place because I do not want to have anything to do with him for the rest of my life, Scarlett.
Mari, aren't you being a little extreme to him? I seriously believe Fabricio is really in love with you.
If he really loved me, he would have told me the truth in the first place.
Oh, Mariana, no one ever says the whole truth to anyone. Everybody lies.
No, Scarlett, no. I just don't want to have a relationship with any man for a really long time. I'm serious. I'm done with men for now.
Mari, tell me, what planet do you live on? That's very impossible.
Not really. For instance, today at the university, I met a really cool gentleman. And I didn't even let him come close.
And was that cool gentleman into you?
Well, we talked for a while. And I guess we flirted a little, Scarlett.
Oh, Mari!
But the poor guy. I was just very, very hard on him that I guess I scared him away.
You think that's funny? What if that guy had the qualities that you're looking for in a man, and you lost that chance to get to know him better because you decided to be a man-hater?
I don't think so, because most men in this country have a lot of baggage. And you know what? I just realized I'm better off alone. I'm serious.
I bet it doesn't last.
Hi there. I'm sorry I'm late.
Don't worry, it's not a problem. That is what friends are for, to wait for each other. Welcome back, Roberto. You want a drink?
Give me one glass of whiskey on the rocks, please.
Whoops. Do you have a problem?
I think I was not being fair, but I already made my decision. I'm divorcing Beatrice. Why are you looking at me like that?
Well, because I never thought that you would be able to do that, and because I thought you would stay with her forever, right?
Well, I guess you're wrong. I just realized that there's no more room in my life for lies. And I'm ready to face the reality of life. And I have to move on, regardless of what will happen.
Have you talked to her?
Yes. I just talked to her a while ago.
Wow. Sir, why don't you serve us now a whiskey on the rocks and make it double, because I want to have a drink with my friend. I'm all ears now. I'm listening.
Oh, Beatrice, please stop drinking now. You'll get sick. Come on, you almost drank it all. Are you insane?
This is perfect, and 11 more to go.
11?
When I found out that Roberto was on his way, I bought a case of his favorite fancy wine. There are 12 bottles. So there's 11 more.
Well then, if that's your problem, then we'll just break them all, or we'll give them away, or whatever you want. But for now, you have to rest.
Juan Carlos, what am I going to do with my life now? Roberto already left me for good.
Roberto's a big idiot. He doesn't deserve your tears. Come on. Come. Let's go.
All relationships that a couple tries to mend won't work out. But all relationships that will end in divorce will find new meaning, because that's the way
but
it is.
It's just that I feel like I'm a criminal. Beatriz is totally messed up, and I'm blaming myself because I know it's my fault.
No. Don't be too hard on yourself, my friend. You don't have to blame yourself and feel so guilty.
Well, I think it's not that easy.
Do you want more?
No. I still have to get up early tomorrow.
Well, brace yourself now. If you want to go to bed with those ladies, just let me know. I think those sexy ladies want to wage war. Cheer up, my friend. You just decide to be single once again.
Are they?
Hmm? So what?
Well, yes, I'm single again, and I do like sexy ladies.
Well then, let's go and get them.
No.
What's the matter?
No. No, it's because those sexy ladies are not the type of women that I like to spend my time with.
You don't like them, can't you see, my friend? They are like sizzling hot.
Oh, yes, they are sizzling hot, and there's no doubt about that, but I don't know. I'm looking for something special.
Something special?
How many times have we been out with women like them?
I don't know, a lot.
Well, exactly. But I want a different life now. Even if it means sleeping alone in my bed tonight. Anyway, thank you so much for listening to my sad story, okay?
Anytime, my friend.
A red rose? A rose like the one you put on his jacket.
But I improved the design of the rose. Oh. It really looks more beautiful.
Oh, yes, it's so beautiful, Mariana. Thank you so much. If I will wear this dress, I'm sure I'll be the star in the university.
Scarlett, please promise me that you're going to take your studies seriously.
Oh, don't worry, Mariana. Listen, I know how to maximize the opportunities given to me, okay? My career begins today.
Mm-hmm. Now you're talking.
Thank you so much.
Well, now I have to go because I can't be late for Mr. Cifuentes.
Well, good luck. Mwah. Mwah.
Bye, Daddy.
Okay, bye.
Nice to meet you. Scarlett with a double D.
Yes, Angela. Here she is.
Mariana Garcia. She's working the shop downtown. I told her that she won the scholarship yesterday.
A sales lady?
Yes, sir. She's a sales lady and a business-minded one. She told me that she wanted to speak with you to make a business proposal.
Good. Very much willing to listen to her business proposal for the company.
Should I schedule an appointment?
Yes.
Well, I don't want to pressure you, Mr. Roberto, but I think you have to leave now for the textile fair.
Oh, yes. You're right. Thank you for reminding me.
Scarlett, do you think they will allow us to get into this fair?
And why not?
Because you don't have an invitation for this kind of fair, neither do I. We are just a couple of gatecrashers here, okay?
Hey, don't say that. We are not gatecrashers here, Adriana. We are models. Remember, we're models, and models enter that way.
Models, Scarlett? How can you say that we could pass for models?
Trust me. And you will see they will allow us to get inside.
And what does a model look like?
Like this. Oh, follow me. But of course, you have to open your eyes, Adriana. Come on. Look, you have to be serious, like that, and you're angry. Then you have to tighten your jaw and show your kissable lips. And chest out. Then walk like this. Follow me. Come on. Good morning.
Hey. Well, Miguel, in this country, there are people who have great tolerance for different crimes. And believe it or not, almost everyone wants to fight for the textile contraband, but nobody can still get rid of the contraband.
Well, I think it's not that easy to get rid of because it's impossible.
Yes, you have a point on that, but that's already the typical crime tolerance syndrome. And that is why most of the areas in this country are damaged.
Okay, we're in trouble. Let's go to the bar now, all right?
No, not now. I don't want to drink. No, I'm not in the mood to drink.
And who told you that we'll drink? That's where we can find sexy ladies who are like models, sizzling hot.
No.
Come on.
Yeah.
Do you see what I see, my friend?
Remember, chin up, chin up. Come on up.
Yes.
Look at those guys over there.
Where?
Two beautiful ladies.
Yes, they are so beautiful.
They're pretty cute, right?
Okay, but let's go now. Don't mind them. Come on.
They're so freaking hot, right?
Yes, they look so hot and sexy.
They are headed to the bar.
I'm thirsty.
And I think I'm dehydrated.